Okay, so during my talk, I'm going to present the lipids and their properties in the optic of 2D crystallization of membrane proteins. So this is an overview of my talk. Lipids, so definition of lipid classification, physical properties of lipids. So it's very important to know how lipids behave in order to use it for 2D crystallization. And I will talk briefly of, I will present briefly new lipids which have been synthesized for 2D crystallization of membrane protein on lipid monolayer. So there are large variety of compounds which are called lipids. So the definition of lipid is very broad. So lipids, the definition is any molecule, molecular weight 105,000 that contains a substantial portion of aliphatic or aromatic hydrocarbons. So this is a list of lipids, hydrocarbon, oil, waxes, and up to detergent and surfactants. So knowing this large chemical variety, the physical behavior will be different from one detergent, one lipid to another. And of course, those lipids have a very key function in biology. So the one very interesting characteristic of lipid is that some are extremely soluble in extremely or partially soluble in water, but some others are completely totally insoluble in water. And this is due to the fact that lipids are amphiphilic structure. So Michael talked previously about this amphiphilic structure. So briefly, I will remind that there is a hydrophilic group and a lipophilic group. This is a characterization of amphiphilic structure. The hydrophilic group can be made of this compound, polar compound, sugar, zwitterionic groups. And the lipophilic group is usually acyl chains. And so the behavior of the lipids in water is mainly due to this hydrophilic-lipophilic balance, HLB. And this is, in fact, related to this structure here. The hydrophilic groups will bind tightly to water. And in order to move this hydrophilic group into solvent, organic solvent, this will require some energy, dehydration of this hydrophilic group, and sometimes it requires some detergent, some energy, quite a lot of energy. And this is the same apply conversely for this lipophilic group. Lipophilic group got a hydrophobic area, and it will require some energy for this area to solubilize in water. So the lipid classification is based on interaction with water rather than on chemical structure. So there are two big class of lipids, and there are some subcategories. So first category is the non-polar lipids. So they are insoluble in water. They form some kind of lens at the air-water interface. They don't form any monolayer. There is no surface solubility, and they are very soluble in organic solvents such as hexane and chloroform or benzene. So the second category is the polar lipids. So usually they are the surface solubility. There are three classes. Class one is insoluble in water, non-swelling. So they just form a very stable monolayer at the air-water interface, and they don't solubilize in pure water. And for example, cholesterol belongs to this class. Class two are insoluble in water, but they are unstable at the interface. So they are insoluble in water. The water will solubilize in the hydrophilic part of the lipids, and they will form some lipid lamellar phase or hexagonal phase. So the lipid from membrane, biological membrane, usually belongs to this class two. And class three are the soluble amphiphiles, so they form unstable monolayer at the air-water interface. They are in constant equilibrium with the water here, and they form not only they can form lamellar, hexagonal, but also micelles. So this is one example of category 2 class 2 lipids. So lipids from membrane protein. So the characteristic lipid bilayer is due to the behavior of lipids. So there is a very tight cohesion between the hydrophobic part of the lipids, van der Waals interaction or non-covalent interaction between the hydrophobic part of the lipids. So this lipid bilayer is formed due to the specific behavior of those lipids. So I'm not going to elaborate on that, but we'll go directly to the structure of those membrane lipids. So I think it's quite important to know the structure of the lipids in detail in order to understand their behavior and in order to use them for 2D crystallization of membrane protein. So there are three kinds of lipids, phospholipids, glycolipids, and cholesterol. So usually phospholipids are made with four components. The backbone is the glycerol, fatty acid, phosphate, and alcohol. So this is the hydrophilic part of the lipid, and this is the hydrophobic part of the lipid. So this is the simplest phospholipid, phosphatidates, with just the phosphate group here. So some common glycerolipids here. So you see the hydrophobic part here made with acid chain. This is a glycerol part, and this is a phosphate plus amino alcohol here, which forms the alcohol with the ester bond here. So we've got the phosphatidylcholine line, the most common lipids, PE, PS, phosphatidylserine, phosphatidylinositol with the sugar here, phosphatidylglycerol, and here a particular case is a cardiolipid. The head group is made with the phosphatidic glycerol linked to two phospholipids. So the fatty acids, so in order to understand the behavior of lipids in water, I know it's very important to describe all the components of those lipids. So this is fatty acid are attached to the glycerol backbone through ester bond, and so this is the structure of the fatty acid, which gives the hydrophobic property of the lipid. So it's made of a hydrocarbon chain, with various lengths and various degrees of insaturation, and this is a carboxylic acid group. So this is one of the most common acyl chain, stearic acid. So the nomenclature is C18 for the number of carbon and 0 is for the number of insaturation. In that case, there is no insaturation. So here is the C18. So the systematic name is octadecanoic acid, the stearic, which is a common name, with one insaturation is called octadecenoic and so on. So those are the most common fatty acid. So from C12 until C20, and you note that the number of carbon is always an even number. This is due to the related to the synthesis of those lipids in cells. So the structure of the fatty acid, so their characteristic structure. So here, so this is the most stable acyl chain. Completely saturated. The distance between two carbon is 1.53 angstrom. The increment distance between two carbon is 1.27 angstrom. And there is straight conformation. So with the trans unsaturation, the structure is also linear. But with the cis insaturation, there is a kink here. And you understand that in the lipid bilayer, the saturated chain will form a very compact structure. But if you have this kind of lipids in a bilayer, they will form a kink and some defects in the membrane. And this explains why the transition temperature is different from this one to saturated to cis unsaturated form. Because here you've got a very, you maximize the van der Waals interaction in this part of the molecule. But here you introduce some defects. So this will have an influence on the transition temperature, but I will talk about that in detail later. So there is also the sphingolipid, which is another phospholipid. Instead of having the glycerol as a backbone, it's a sphingosine with an acyl chain, and this is an amino alcohol. Usually this lipid is not used for constituting membrane protein and lipid bilayer. And also, there are the glycolipids here, and I'm not going to elaborate on that because usually we don't use this kind of lipid for reconstitution of membrane protein for 2D crystallization. So the cholesterol is quite interesting because the structure is completely different from any other lipids, as it is a steroid. So there are four link hydrocarbon rings here. This is the OH, this is the hydrophilic group here. So this structure is quite small, but insert in the lipid bilayer. And in some cases, I think Daniel maybe will mention that. Daniel managed to crystallize an ABC transporter into using the cholesterol. So in some cases, the cholesterol might be important for crystallization. So in order to know the exact composition of a membrane, biological membrane, exact composition of lipid, this is a protocol to follow. So we have to extract the lipid using a mixture of chloroform and ethanol. So after extraction of the lipid are separated on the thin layer chromatography, one dimension and second and two dimension, and this give some information, qualitative and quantitative information, about the composition of the lipid and phospholipid of biological membrane. So now I'm going to talk more about the behavior of lipids in water. So in water, the lipid spontaneously aggregates. And in order to bury the hydrophobic part of the molecule at the interior, inside, and expose the hydrophilic part of the molecule. And so this is called, this is a hydrophobic effect. So, and they can, the lipid can have various, can show various structures, either a two-dimensional structure, such as lamella or hexagonal, or they can have a three-dimensional structure, such as cubic phase. And the liotropic transition is the study of those various phases varying the water content at constant temperature. So here, for example, for the two-dimensional, those are the main phases for the two-dimensional. So you can have a lamellar phase or hexagonal phase, but according to the component of water, composition, variation of water content, you can have various phase, gel phase, which is extremely viscous, and liquid phase. And also with the hexagonal phase, here when you don't have a lot of water, you got the water here inserted inside this tube, or when you increase the amount of water, you've got hexagonal phase. You go from a reverse phase to hexagonal phase. And also, so those are the 3D conformations. So this, for example, cubic phase has been used for crystallization, 3D crystallization of membrane protein. So the polymorphism of lipid is very important. The shape of the lipid is very important for the polymorphism for the phase. So, for example, a bulky lipid here with a large head group will form rather some micelles. A cylindrical lipid will form flat bilayer, or here cardiolipid, for example, with a small head group will form inverted micelles. So I think I will skip that. And so eventually we can draw some very, sometimes very complicated phase diagram about and describing the various phases of the lipid. So lipid phase transition, I think this is quite important because at certain temperatures, the lipid goes from a gel phase to a liquid phase. In the gel phase, the lipid is extremely viscous, and in the liquid crystal phase, the lipid is very mobile. In the bilayer, the thickness is decreased, and so the urea per molecule is bigger, increase. And so usually when we work with lipid, we tend to use those lipid at higher temperatures than the transition temperature. So for example, here I marked here the lipid which are used for crystallization. DLPC, for example, the TM fast transition is minus one, so at 20 degrees it will be quite fluid. Yes. So those are pure lipid. So yeah, Manu, yes, it's what you say is true, because in the case of DMPC, the transition temperature is 23 and crystals have been formed using this lipid. So I think you are right.
It's not like microplane.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think it really depends also on the proline properties.
Mm-hmm. So, and there, so I'm going to go there quickly. So you, when you mix lipids, so there are also the study of fast transition of mixture of lipid, and this is in addition of what Andrea said, sometimes you can have some fast transition when you mix lipid, which have a transition temperature which is quite far apart. You have, when you increase the temperature, you have some fast transition of the lipid, and you have clearly some domains of one lipid and domain of other lipid. So, and this is the effect of the cholesterol on fast transition. Usually, the cholesterol has little effect on the position of the fast transition, but abolish completely the heat of transition. So mobility of protein, I'm going to skip that. The typical lipid used for 2D crystallization, I think you are going to talk about that later. But I just want to mention this important property of lipid, which are used to form the lipid monolayer for the 2D crystallization. So this is a technique of 2D crystallization on lipid monolayer. So this is an elegant method where you've got the lipid monolayer here, the protein binds to this kind of support. And then eventually the detergent is removed, and you have some, when you are lucky, you've got some two-dimensional crystals here. So those are the reconstitution lipid, reconstituting lipid, and those are the lipid which helps the formation of the lipid, of the formation of the 2D crystal. And it's extremely important that those lipids are there, which are at the air-water interface, are fluid. And it's extremely important that those lipids are in the liquid expanded phase. And in a way to check that the lipids that you are using here are in the liquid expanded phase, you need to do this experiment with a long Weierfield balance. So it's simple experiment where you spread your lipid at the interface and you push the barrier and you monitor in real time the surface pressure using the Willy-Lemmy plate. So usually the lipid goes from the gaseous phase, where there's absolutely no interaction between the lipid, expanded phase, where there is a slight interaction between the tail of the lipid, condensed phase, which is a semi-solid phase, and the solid phase, which is extremely viscous. And then if you push even more, you got the collapse. So a good lipid, the behavior of a good lipid should collapse at this level here. So you go from the gaseous phase, expanded phase, and then you should have the collapse here. So the collapse is when the surface pressure falls. Well, okay. So just quickly some lipid, but I think Daniel will talk more about that. The lipid which are used for the crystallization of membrane protein as the lipid monolayer interface. The thing is when you want to crystallize membrane protein on a lipid monolayer interface, it's complicated by the fact that there are some detergent in the solution which can solubilize the lipid monolayer. So in that case, you need to use some fluorinated lipid which help to keep the detergent away from the lipid monolayer and binding of the membrane protein. Okay, so that's it. So there are the reference here. So there are some very good textbooks about the lipid, and this one is very good, so it's more advanced, or there are some general textbooks about lipids. Thank you. Yeah. No, no, you don't see for all the lipids. This is a complete sequence,
yeah.
But you don't see, often you don't see all the sequence. But for example, if you want to use a lipid which collapsed in the condensed phase, it's better not to use it for to form the lipid monolayer there.
Sure. So how do you tell when you look at it?
Because there are some plateau here. It's clear. It's got a for the after the gaseous and expanded phase, and then another plateau, and so on. No, no, usually gaseous is quite, when you got a very, no, gaseous phase, you know, it's this, you can monitor that because, you know how much lipid you put on your surface. And this is quite easy to monitor because
yeah,
you, yeah, and this is, yeah. Okay.